And now we are going to set up the registers that we will use to record transactions. Register windows are where you record the transactions. You need a register window for each financial account. After we open the register for each account, we will put them in the icon bar for convenience. Let's take a look at how to do this. First, we have to open our good friend, the chart of accounts. From the top left of the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts. Now, since we will use this chart of accounts often, let's put it up in the icon bar. The way to pin something up in the icon bar is to make sure that it's the active window, in this case it's the only window open, and click View. And when you click View, whatever the active window is will show up here, seven choices down, Add Chart of Accounts to the icon bar. Click on it, and we will talk about these details later. For now, just click OK, and here we have a shortcut to the icon bar. We have a shortcut actually to the chart of accounts. Excuse me, the shortcut is in the icon bar. When we close this out, we can click the shortcut and it will open up and we won't have to bother going to the main menu. There are two ways to open a register window for your financial accounts. One way is from the chart of accounts. If you double click, for example, here on Chase Bank, a window opens up with the title bar Chase Bank, and in the body of the window you see something that looks just like the old style register books that our parents and grandparents used to record their bank account transactions. Notice that there's a field for each piece of information one would need when recording bank transactions. There's a field for the date, the check number, whom you paid, money amount, whether it's a deposit or payment, and of course you could write the reason on the second row. A register in this format requires two lines for every one transaction. If you close it out, you could double click Capital One and notice the same thing happens. The computer knows Capital One is a credit card type of account, so this register window has slightly different words in the title bars going across the columns. But it's basically the same thing. And again, in the old days before the computer, this is the type of booklet, or this is what the booklet looked like when our parents and grandparents recorded their credit card charges. The other way to open up these register windows would be to close the chart of accounts and from the main menu click Banking, Use Register. In this little window we can choose which register we want to open. So if we again click Chase Bank and click OK, we get the very same register window that opened a moment ago from the chart of accounts. Now, before we save this into the icon bar, let's change the way it looks. I don't think it's very efficient to have two lines for every one transaction. The information is spread out and is not as easy for your eyes to see if you're searching for a specific transaction. I strongly recommend you move the mouse to the bottom left of the window and click the one line box. Now you have every transaction in one line. This way, when you start to record many Chase Bank transactions, your eyes will more easily see and find the transaction you're looking for. Now that it looks the way we want it to look, we're going to save it to the icon bar. Just like we did a minute ago, click View, Add Chase Bank to the icon bar, and then click OK. Let's close it out and add all of the registers that we need for each of our financial accounts to the icon bar. Banking, Use Register, and this time we'll choose T&M Bank. Click OK and the T&M Bank register opens up. Go down to the bottom left and click One Line. Now that it looks the way we need it to look, click View, Add TNM to the icon bar, and click OK. If you close it out, you can see how convenient it is. Open Chase Bank, open TNM Bank. We can even have both windows open at the same time if we're recording many transactions at once. Let's finish up. Banking, Use Register, choose Capital One Credit Card, then click OK. Remember, before you save it to the icon bar, you should click the one line box. Now it looks proper. View, add Capital One to the icon bar, click OK. We're almost finished. Banking, Use Register, choose Chase Freedom. Click OK. Make sure you click the one line button to make sure it's easier to read. Now click View, add Chase Freedom to the icon bar, and then click OK. Again, Banking, Use Register. Now we'll choose PayPal, and then click OK. Now go to the bottom left, click one line, and click View, add PayPal to the icon bar, and click OK. Now we'll do the last one. Banking, Use Register, and we're going to choose Petty Cash or Cash and Wallet. Click OK. Click the one line button. Click View. Add Petty Cash to the icon bar and click OK. Now, anytime you have a transaction to or from any of these financial accounts, all you have to do is click on it from the icon bar and record the information about that transaction across the line.